you, and he took you to the limit before you went on to win EVO 8 2012.
Yeah, it's it was definitely a strong contest. John, he kicked me right in the face. I literally tasted it 2 weeks after that.
Wow. Mm-hmm. You know, my thing, like I was telling Chris Shore earlier, John Schuyler has all the talent, whether he's imitating
you. Actually,
he doesn't.
He doesn't have any talent whatsoever.
He uses Ty Dillon. I just disagree how
he uses. That was a nice little slide back to the corner, very animated. You call that talent?
What he does have is Ty Dillinger in his corner. And
against the turnbuckle.
What we've seen so far tonight is.
Have you tried to do that?
No, I generally like to beat my opponents and pin them to the mat.
That's why you're champ, champ.
John Schuyler, Corey Hollis here, our first of two semifinal matches. Fans, we still do not know who Cedric Alexander will face in the second semifinal match tonight.
Interesting.
Still waiting for an announcement.
Can the Evo champion enter the Evo 8 to win it so he doesn't have to face anybody? Is that possible, Zach?
I guess it's possible.
Hey, a very nice hurricanrana there by Corey Hollis. He was on the mat. He had his back on the mat, and he nipped up Schuyler back to the turnbuckle again to rethink his thoughts.
Corey Hollis did have a very impressive showing against Joe Black. Joe Black handled him pretty good there the first part, but, you know, out of all the four opening matches for the first round, Zach, you can attest to this, Corey's was the quickest. It was about 8.5 minutes. The key to Evo 8 is keeping your stamina, not getting in these long battles, these wars that some of the guys that have advanced to the second round have. John Schuyler had a 15-minute match with Caleb Connolly where they went back and forth, back and forth.
Corey Hollis has had a longer time to rest as well.
Yeah.
But Hollis giving up a lot of size here. Unlike the first match where he and Joe Black built very similar, he's giving up a lot of size here to Schuyler.
That's interesting. I was about to say the same thing. Ironically, John Schuyler is the bigger man in this match. So definitely interesting to see how he's going to use that to his advantage. You were talking about Schuyler getting rest and Corey getting rest and about how his match was only 8 minutes long. Well, you could say that, but you got to also think ahead. Bouncing off what you were saying, using the lily pad, so to speak, whoever wins this match is going to go face a very, very fresh Cedric Alexander.
We don't know that for sure yet, Zach. We haven't got word on that. That is speculation right now. That's what some of the rumblings are saying that, but we have not got confirmation.
We have no idea what Cedric Alexander is going
hopefully
to do.
Hopefully, but after the match, we can get confirmation. But if that was the case, you are 100% correct. Whoever wins this match is really going to be handicapped. I agree 100%.
Hollis now with that side headlock on John Schuyler. Schuyler drives him back into the corner. And, of course, the other thing that Corey Hollis has got to watch out for tonight, besides giving up some size here, is Ty Dillinger. Ty, of course, before the match, saying that the spoiler alert is John Schuyler.
Straight to the face by Corey Hollis.
Corey Hollis said he was a man on a mission tonight. There went the hammy.
Yep. He's pulled up.
That's a knee. I think he is definitely
It's a knee now.
He landed. That looks like it's some type of ligament.
And watch out here. Ty Dillinger closing in on him here. We've already seen him involved twice tonight in Schuyler's first match. Corey Hollis has got to have eyes in the back of his head. Now they're fighting right now here below us. Zach, tell us about what it takes to get through this part of the tournament. I mean, you've already had your opening round match. You're in the semifinals now. You know you've got one more after this. What's your approach? Schuyler just lights up Corey Hollis' chest with a chop there. What's the approach to a match like this, knowing that you need to give it all to win, but yet hold something back for that final?
Well, to be fair, you're not thinking about that whatsoever. You're thinking about your opponent at the time. I can remember last year. This tournament, I was in a very similar situation to Corey Hollis. I had hurt my knee against John Schuyler, and then I had re-injured the knee during the match with Cedric Alexander last year. And at that point, I wasn't thinking about conserving myself. I was thinking about winning the match and not hurting myself anymore. So at this point, I guarantee Corey Hollis is thinking about win quick, of course, but he's trying to also stay healthy. John Schuyler is going to definitely try to meticulously take apart that knee.
Schuyler here being smart about this, working the leg and the rope is not the nicest move, but a lot of Hollis's grounded pound ability comes from having a solid base, and if he's got a weak, he's got a bad wheel.
And don't discount Hollis's high flying maneuverability. He will fly every now and then. down, man. It's hard to
springboard. How can he fly? He's limited. He's got a hurt knee. Now.
Exactly. It's hard to do that. It's hard to do a springboard when you can't put pressure on your left knee.
This is where Schuyler shows his youth right here. He's paintbrushing.
Great drop kick.
Exactly. He's just paintbrushing, showing him disrespect when he could have gone for a pin. He could have gone for some type of submission, but no.
Schuyler checking his bridge there.
I mean, he's got Ty out there on the apron. That's his job to run it back.
Yeah.
Now, begging off a look.
See, this is where we disagree, Zach. I think John Schuyler does have a lot of talent. The problem is he's still.
Oh, and look out here. Look out here, Ty. He uses it from behind.
Oh.
Again, just with the point of his shoes. He's got the wingtips out there kicking Corey Hollis.
What do you mean the wingtips?
It's a solid shoe.
Are you like a fashion guru now?
Maybe.
Okay. Anyway, what I was saying there with Schuyler, though, is that he takes the easy pass. He gloats too much. He's too full of himself.
I mean, I'm no stranger to taking the easy path. When in doubt, grab hold. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I mean, you don't see me paintbrushing people out there, because if you paintbrush them, you can punch them.
And, yeah, exactly. And that, and also.
That is a smart maneuver.
Yeah.
He is using the ring to his advantage.
This isn't
up against the post.
This isn't some bar.
Punch it on the knee now.
Everybody in the Evo 8 tournament is fully capable of winning it, and they're one of the elite wrestlers in the Southeast. You can't basically gloat and showboat. You need to finish the matches as quickly as possible. You need to hurt your opponent.
I agree. Why are you taking my stance? You just contradicted yourself.
I'm not taking it. I said he needs to do that.
John Schuyler, not the guy who was here in last year's Evo 8 tournament. Certainly an improved wrestler over 2012, showing it here, but with the same predilection from last time, taking his eye off the ball, showboating with Ty Dillinger at ringside. He needs to focus on this knee and focus on putting Corey Hollis away here.
Yeah, you see what he just did right there. He was going for a patented sharpshooter. Straight for the knee, a great maneuver for a man with an injured knee. Instead, he wants to show off and gloat. Now he's got to wear him back down again.
Now can he do that knee buster there?
But while doing that, he's wasting energy. He's taking more fuel out of the tank by doing all the
time out. Don't try to overthink this, okay? You're gonna back yourself up into a corner. We're gonna be sitting there.
And could he get the figure four? Yes, he does. Right in the middle of the ring, the Southern Singer has Corey Hollis in trouble. And now punching on that knee.
Look at this shit.
And look out, look at Ty Dillinger from behind.
Now,
that's
smart. That's intelligent. I'm not going to hold it against him. That is very intelligent.
He's reaching back for some extra leverage.
He's got to do something here.
Hollis trying to punch out. Schuyler flopping back, though, smartly.
He's already been in and I've clocked it already for 45 seconds. That knee, that shin, the left leg, it's got to be about to just snap. You can see the torque being put on it from here, folks.
I mean, it'd also be interesting to say that Corey's got to get off of his back, too, because that's how they pinball maneuver.
John Schuyler has had this hole locked in for quite some time now. And the referee, Rich Mitch Blaylock, sees it finally there.
I think that's the first time in about 10 years Mitch Blaylock has actually seen it. Just kidding on that, Mitch, but seriously. Now he needs to make a break.
He can break the hole.
He needs a qualification if he doesn't want to break it.
Now John Schuyler making a mistake here, arguing with our referee. If he wants to win this match, he needs to stay on Corey Hollis and put him down.
Look.
Now.
Showboating again. And there's
that close was John Schuyler to being pinned here. Corey Hollis trying to power him over here in the bridge. He's got him two and a
four. Oh, goodness.
Trying to back down. He's got him rolling again.
Hollis has come alive here. He's fighting for his EOA tournament life.
Schuyler back to that leg, and you again see what happens when you get a guy with a bad wheel. The DDT on the foot.
I must give the devil his due right there. I'm not a big fan of John Schuyler. John Schuyler is a big fan of me.
I agree 100%. Here comes Tom Dillinger.
But John Schuyler.
See, now I see what he's doing, but he really, I don't know. You tell me, Zach. I think I see what he's doing. He's putting more pain and punishment on the leg. Well, he really needs to think about getting this match early. Like you said, he's probably going to face Cedric Alexander in the finals with Cedric completely fresh and not even having a semifinal match. Do you think he should continue this, or do you think he should he's leaving himself open?
Well, the mindset of doing such a maneuver like this is to he's attempted, he's put him in the figure four.
Right.
It failed.
Right.
Now he has to wear him back down again to reapply a maneuver similar or the same one.
Would you consider going to a different area of the body? Obviously, he isn't going to submit. He was in the figure four for over a minute and a half. He didn't tap out.
Maybe try a different maneuver on the knee.
Okay.
Wouldn't go to a different body part.
Scott, he's going for the sliced bread here. That's his move. If he can hit this, it's going to be off for Hollis. But Hollis, we're going to get you back
out.
I can't believe he dropped him on the top rope.
That was impressive.
The heart that it took for Corey Hollis to lift him up and hold him.
Oh, what a clothesline by Corey Hollis. Now, Zach, you had many a time, like you said last year, your leg was just completely obliterated nearly by the end of the event. How did you fight through it? You were able to beat the Manscow pretty much on one wheel. Y'all had a 20-plus minute back and forth. Falls count anywhere. How were you able to block out the pain?
Two things. Stay out of any type of hold with the knee. Second thing, you're lucky that you can
quickly here, guys. We're up to an 8 count. If the referee gets 10, we'd have another double count out. Hollis makes his feet.
Another forearm to the head. Scott takes one.
There you go.
Now Hollis starting to put together some moves here. Floats over into a cover.
Oh. That was
very good. Corey Hollis has got to find a way to end this match quickly.
Look. Oh! Is he going for a clash? If so, that's Hollis's move. But Hollis, look at that strength, comes up and over.
Oh, but he went on that knee
and
there.
It's funny on that leg.
Oh! I think I just saw blood fly out of his mouth.
He's roaring back elbow.
One, two, and go!
Is that a three?
No, just there's
now
two,
Hollis,
nine, five.
Hollis has him twisted over here. He's got Hidella just right there. Look at the way Skylar's body is twisted. He's either going to have to tap or make that rope. Ty Dillinger there to encourage him on reaching out for his hand.
It's got to be hard for Hollis, though, to really put all his weight into that move because he needs to use his left leg to twist.
And did you see Dillinger there push the rope in so that Skylar could grab it? Once again, we see the difference that this guy makes being in Skylar's corner. And now he's up on the apron. Corey Hollis needs to watch out. Look out behind you, kid.
Very smart by John Skylar moving out of the way. And then very smart by Ty to stop.
Oh, he spit right in Ty's face.
What is it?
Oh, the spear.
The great equalizer.
One, two, and oh, Corey Hollis kicked out.
God. Look at Skylar. He can't believe it.
Back on Corey Hollis. Immediately he's on his back. He may have kicked out, but that took all of his energy. Again, showing his age. Showing the youth.
See, he needs to jump right, like you said, Zach. He needs to get on him.
He needs to get on.
I mean, Ty Dillinger pretty much opened the door for him.
Oh, and now he's setting up the super kick here. He's calling for it. Watch out, Hollis. Oh, Corey smartly comes down, but look.
Go right back.
There it is.
There he's going for that shot. That's his move.
Look at Payne. Hollis is screaming.
Look at Hollis's face. Look at him.
It may be in his best shot of his career to tap out right now.
Don't listen to Ty. He's going to tie. Bring it back.
Corey Hollis fighting, trying to get to the ropes. Can he make it?
There's no way in hell.
No way. And it rolls up. Two and no. Skylar able to get out the last second there. I thought he might have him stacked up enough.
Oh. Oh, my God.
Hollis has shown unbelievable resilience, but he's out cold. One, two, and no. He kicked out.
Be
the resiliency here shown by Corey Hollis. Zach, you've got to, even as champ, you got to.
And now look, it's unbelievable. Come to this.
The only thing that I can say about that kick out right there is that he's just muscle memory.
Yeah.
Muscle memory.
If John Skyler is for this, it's a disqualification.
The ref's right there. The ref is smart. He should take it from him. There we go.
Him up. Could he hit the clash again?
Was holding John Schuyler back.